صلاح والدكتور محمد حواش. انا سعيد بوجودي في مستشفى البطنه. وازاي يمكن الدكتور نادر ربيعتين قال في الصيدله في الاول؟ احنا كان عندنا ورك شوب النهارده من الساعه 10 للساعه 12 12 ونص فوق نيرسس عن انفكشن. الدكتوره قالت كلام كويس جدا جدا جدا. للاسف الشديد كان النمبر اتندنس مستشفى البطنه في ثلاث ولايات.
حضرتك كانوا جايين من مركز الكلى والمسالك. فيعني ان شاء الله المره الجايه يمكن الاستاذه الدكتوره ياسمين صلاح هي رئيس فريق مكافحه العدوى في مستشفى البطنه، وهي اكيد قالت كلام كتير وعملت ندوات وعملت محاضرات وعملت ورك شوبس. بس كنا نتمنى النهارده ان الاخوات الممرضات يجوا يحضروا للاستاذه الدكتوره هاله. هي الحقيقه كانت عندنا محاضرة جميلة جدا 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 وباللغة العربية وبسيطة جدا على قد مستوى الناس. دلوقتي الأستاذ الدكتور ياسمين صلاح اتفضل.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أولا أنا بشكر اللجنة المنظمة للمؤتمر وبخاصة الشكر للأستاذ الدكتور بجانب على دعوته لنا إن إحنا نكون رؤساء هذه الجلسة. وإن شاء الله المؤتمر القادم هيكون لنا حضور برؤساء جلسات وفي برزنتيشن 2، لأن إحنا ماسكين مستشفى البطنة من سنين طويلة كمكافحة عدوى، والحمد لله الواحد حاسس إن يعني له بصمة موجودة ويعني مستمرة معانا بعد إن شاء الله، وإحنا مخرجنا كانت مستمرة للنواب والممرضات و فإن شاء الله المرة الجاية بتشوفوا تجربتنا على البطنة في الخمس ست سنين اللي فاتوا عملنا إيه وإيه اللي استفدناه ويا رب يكون في بلادنا. برحب بالدكتورة هالة. مرحبا بالدكتوره هاله، اهلا وسهلا بحضرتك وان شاء الله تفضلي بقى في البرزنتيشن. مستوى البريفنشن. ففي عندنا نورويج سيرجن قال ان although the hospital may not be the mother of bulimia it is its nurse. فطبعا المستشفيات بتكون مصدر للانفكشن. What does infection control control كونسيرن فور. طبعا عندنا في الستاندرد بريكوشن والهاند هايجين والبيرسونال بروتكتيف اكويبمنت والديسبوزال اوف شارب والبروبر هاندلنج اوف لينن وكليننج وديس انفكشن. والحقيقه في التشين اوف نوزوكوميال انفكشن زي ما احنا عندنا بيبقى فيه انفكشوس ايجنت والريسيرفوار والبورتال اوف اكزيت والترانسميشن مود والبورتال اوف انتري والسبتا والهوست. وطول ما الحاجات دي موجوده بدون ان احنا نقدر نتحكم فيها فبتبقى التشين موجوده وتؤدي الى العدوى. فهاو تو بريك ذا تشين اوف نوزوكوميال انفكشن، احنا عندنا طبعا في الهوسبيتال في الهيلث كير وركر وفي البيشنت والممارسات المختلفه وبينهم هما الاثنين المايكرو اورجانيزم بتنتقل. وفهاو تو بريك ذيس تشين طبعا بالانفكشن كنترول بروسيدرز. وطبعا التشين هنا في كل خطوه منها، يعني احنا عشان نتحكم في الانفكشوس ايجنت محتاجين طبعا رابيد اكيوريت ايدنتيفيكيشن اوف اورجانيزم، والريسيرفوار محتاجين انفايرمنتال سانيتيشن وامبلوي هيلث وديس انفكشن وسترلايزيشن، والبورتال اوف انتري محتاجين بروبر اتاير وهاند ووشنج وتراش ويست ديسبوزال وكنترول اوف اكسكريشن اند سكريشن، والمين اوف ترانسميشن محتاجين للايزوليشن والفود هاندلنج واير فلو كنترول وسترلايزيشن وهاند ووشنج. في البورتال اوف اكزيت محتاجين اسيبتك تكنيك وكاسيتر كير ووند كير، وفي السبتا والهوست محتاجين تريتمنت اوف اندرلاين ديزيز. فكل مرحله عشان نقدر نعمل لها بريك محتاجه للبريكوشنز بتاعتها. فالانفكشن كنترول براكتس اند بروسيدجر، طبعا من كده في الانفكشن كنترول دكتور انفكشن كنترول نيرس بيبقى في ديفرنت بوليسيز اند بريكوشنز خاصه بالكلينيكال ديبارتمنت واللابوراتوريز والكوميونتي ستاف والبابليك هيلث والفارماسي والسبلاي والبورتر والدوميستكس والكاترينج واللاندري والامبلوي والسبيشال وركر في السبيشال ديبارتمنت از سترلايزيشن ان ذا سكوب اوف ريتنج ثيتر نيرسينج ستاف اند اوكيوبيشنال هيلث. فأول حاجة طبعا عندنا الهاند هايجين. فلو قلنا what are the 10 most important causes of transmission of infection، طبعا the most important not the causes of transmission of infection but the most important are our 10 fingers because by fingers you transmit the infection from the source to the patient or the surfaces or the environment. والحقيقه هنا الترانسميشن اوف انفكشن بيبقى سهل جدا، مثلا زي هنا من الاوكر للايد او من الاي هاند للايد او من الايد للفود او during shaking hand، وبرده من خلال الكمبيوتر وبيستخدم دلوقتي طبعا في المستشفيات كتير، وبرده الفلوس تبقى source of transmission of infection. وهنا طبعا زي ما احنا شايفين ان هنا ان ده ميديا وعليها هنا ال hand of one of the healthcare worker، نشوف ان هو الجروس بيبقى limited to the side of the hand. فديمونستريشن هنا by putting the tips of the finger. Here you can see that this is unwashed the hand. فبنلاقي هنا heavy gross and this is rinsed hand less heavy gross and this is washed 20 seconds using soap and water still there is microorganism and then but washed 20 seconds after and then sanitized so there is no gross at all. So this is a proof of the effect of washing and disinfecting of the hand. Here this is the hair and the gross is allocated to the side of the hair and this is part of the apron and we find that the gross is around the part of the cloth and this is best fly and so how you can see how the blade is full of gross. It's very important before hand washing you have to remove all the jewelry. Here we put the all the rings here, and you can see different shapes of the ring. And this is after culture. Can you imagine? This is the ring exactly with its shape. And so even this empty bar is still is empty. So it's very important to remove the jewelers. So also infection could be transmitted through the surface. All this green color is source of bacterial contamination. And here you can see the contamination of the bed linen and then of the patient gown and overhead table, blood pressure cuff, side rails, bath door handle, intravenous pump button, and room door handle. So what are the records about hand washing? Very important. A review of 34 published studies of hand washing adherence among healthcare workers found that adherence rates varied from 5 to 81% and the average rate was only at 40%. Why this compliance? There is very low of compliance. Heavy workload, things are poorly located, skin irritation caused by frequent exposure to soap and water, hands don't look dirty, hand washing takes too long time. When a hand washing audit, anything that you could not measure, you could not develop or modify. So you have to measure the level of compliance to hand washing so that you can improve it. And this is through a checklist for description of the department and hand washing resources and practices and observed risk factor for poor adherence and self-reported factor for poor adherence. In our institute, a total of 120 occurrence of patient to contact disease in hand washing, the gross rate of compliance was 40%, can a nurse 44%, a doctor 34%, and a worker 22%. Here in a training after proper hand washing, and then we can apply a material that can detect the presence of bacteria. It colors the site of bacteria with a green color, and then after you put the hand under ultraviolet light, you can see that this is the site of the bacteria appear to be green. So this proves that the hand not properly washed. So clean care is safer care. The 5 moments from the WHO for proper hand hygiene, usually before patient contact and before aseptic task and after body fluid exposure risk and after patient contact. After contact with patient surroundings. Regarding personal protective equipment, it is very important to prevent the swelling of gloves when performing procedure during which splattering of blood might occur. And wearing gloves or caring for the patient, touching the patient equipment to remove gloves and wash hand between each patient or station. One of the most important causes for not to wash the hand is wearing the gloves. Most of the healthcare worker consider that wearing the gloves protects their hand, and this is very wrong because you know wearing the gloves increase the temperature of the hand. And also increase with humidity, and so humidity with increase of temperature together with the time, and this is a very appropriate condition for the bacterial growth. And so you have to wash the hand before wearing the gloves to decrease the number of the bacteria, and after removing the gloves to decrease the number, remove the bacteria after removing the gloves. Handling of device. Single-use item should be disposed of, used only on a single patient. Multiple-use item cleaned and disinfected before, taken to a common clean area or used for another patient. Non-disposable items that cannot be cleaned and disinfected as adhesive tape, cloth covered blood pressure cuffs should be dedicated for use only on a single patient. Drug preparation should be in a clean area away from the patient, with a clean area should be separated from contaminated area. And when multiple dose medication vials are used, prepare individual patient doses and deliver it separately to each patient. Vials should not be shared between patients. Don't carry multiple dose medication vials from station to station. Prevention of vascular access infection. Wash your hands, wear medical gloves, limit contact, clean the skin, and you have to use, we have in Kudorman Heart Research Institute, this central sterilization unit, which could supply all the required sterilizing instrument, and it is constructed for the recent, most updated guideline. Here we can see Al-Jabal. This is the entering, and this is the meeting room where we have window glasses that you can see all the unit from it. And this is the place for changing clothes for male and woman. And this is for receiving the instrument. And then after that, washing, automatic washing. And this is ultrasound for any exposed instrument. And this is inspection before packaging. And this is a cleaning of the trolley after its after transfer of the instrument. And this is for the receival of linen and goods, and then inspection of the gowns and sewing any and here after that packaging for the instrument and for the linen using special boxes, and this is for cleaning of the plastic container and the wrapping with special paper that can allow the steam to penetrate through the linen. And after that, we have the autoclave steam, and then also low-level gas plasma used for all the connection in operating theater, and also accessories of the endoscopes. Reprocessing of endoscope. I will comment only on a few points. First, the unit should be constructed properly, and the endoscope should not be transferred carried by hand. It should be transferred through the trays, and the room for reprocessing should be separated from the room of the patient. The problem with the endoscope is also the presence of biofilm. Here you can see the biofilm. First, there is reversible absorption and then irreversible attachment of the bacteria, followed by growth and division, so increase in number, and then production and the biofilm formation, and then attachment of other organisms to the biofilm that that very easily to be detached and transmit the infection. So detachment, final stage is detachment of microorganisms from the surface of the biofilm. So it is very important for brushing of the channel, and this usually emits the bar. Most of the center either don't have brush, or when they used brush used, and it is didn't probably work, and so you can see here. Here the brush should pass through the channel
get its end out from the other side. So that any debris or biofilm should be removed. Here you can see, when you use the brush, all these debris come out. The brush is passing through the lumen, removing any debris in the endoscope. Here, consider that this is a part of the endoscope, and then we put betadine to test for the effect of the brush. And then, first, we use the brush of the unit, which is used, and you can see this betadine as if it is blood or as if it is remnant in the endoscope. And so when you use the brush, now we introduce the brush as if it is used exactly in the endoscope. Though this is not properly working, so when you remove the brush, you will find that just the betadine is distributed over the channel, and it is still present. So this is actual endoscope, so all the debris and all the remnant of blood will remain. And then we repeat using a properly working brush. Here we put the betadine. And after that, we use the properly working brush. So this is the left. So it is very important to have the brush and the properly working. And because if there is biofilm, even if the endoscope is automatically washed after that and disinfected, there will be biofilm that will be detached during examination. Also regarding the use of disinfectant for disinfection of endoscope, we have the Cydex 2% glutaraldehyde and Cydex Ubat and Verasafe. The level of disinfection for Cydex 2% is medium level, 20 minutes, and if it is high level disinfection, 30 minutes, and 40B, 60 minutes. But Cydex Ubat, 10 minutes for medium and the high level, and Verasafe also 10 minutes. So there's great difference when using Cydex. And also Cydex glutaraldehyde now, it is not, it is recommended not to be used in France and in UK and in Australia, because it may biofilm, and this biofilm cause spread of infection. It's very important regarding cleaning and disinfection in the hospital, the cleaning equipment must be maintained and the cleaning personnel must be trained. And for infectious still, especially in hematemesis cases in internal medicine, we have usually the scattering of blood, and you have to use a special powder. This powder is effervescent granule. and so it will absorb all the fluid in the blood and at the same time contain sodium hydroxyglutarate which will disinfect the blood. And so after that you can collect the blood just with a piece of carton and put it in the red bag. And after that, disinfect the area, and it must be disinfected from outside to inside, and not the usual way. It is a clot of blood, and then comes the worker and spread it all over the ward. This is very dangerous. In every hospital, they have to use all the set of disinfectant for. Hands and for the skin and for instruments that could not affect the instrument or the words on it, and also for the surfaces and for the floor and for the spill as we mentioned, and also for all the plastic connection in operating theater and in intensive care. Storage area should be clean and the waste handling should be proper waste handling, especially for sharp as needle, infusion set, catheter, broken glass. And here could illustrate the sharp box should be made of plastic that is, could not be pierced by the needle, and also should be environmentally friendly so that when it is exposed to high temperature, it does not give dioxin and very bad carcinogenous product. And it should be only filled to three forces and not to be filled full because it, this is, could be broken, could be full and cause infection. And also, it is we have not to recap the needle. This is very important. Not to recap the needle. All the needle it has to be put in the sharp box, and only in two situations that you have to recap the needle. In when the blood gases is required in the intensive care, and you have to cover the needle, and also if it is in your house, and you have to put the needle in the household garbage. And in this case, you have to use one hand technique, but only in this case, otherwise, you have to put all the needle in the box. Here we have after segregation of waste into household waste in black bags and infectious waste in red bags, and then to be transferred three times per day to the waste management unit, and then where it is the red bags with treated with fragmentation and autoclaving, and then put in white bags. To be transferred with the black bag with in a covered cars. And here we can see the design of the unit. Here's the entrance, and this is the meeting room with the supervisor room, and here the room for changing the clothes, and then the fragmentation and autoclave unit. And here this is the room for red bags and for washing of the trolley, and here is that storage area for disinfectant and cleaning material, and also for the trolley and for the bag, and here this room for black bag for household waste. Here you can see the unit. After the entrance, you can see the meeting room. This is a dangerous sign. And this is the meeting room where there is a supervisor and all the documents and the illustration for all the cycle of the install. And this is the diagrammatic presentation for the unit. And there should be every room here. There should be a basin with soap and all the hand hygiene. And this is for changing clothes. And then the room for the instrument for fragmentation and autoclaving. closest to deal with waste. And then they use a control panel to open the cover of the instrument. And then they will wash hands and wear gloves, thick gloves, so that they can bring the red bags with infectious waste from the red bag home. All the bags closed with affies, not with luster and not with tying, because if you tie, you have to press the bag, and so this may cause needlestick injury. And they carry the bags and then upside the stairs to put the bags in the fragmentation and autoclaving instrument. And then down, and they use a control panel to close the door again. Then they have to wash the hand before using the control panel. And by the control panel, close the door. And then about 3/4 of an hour, the cycle. And after that, all the waste reduced to 2/3 of its weight, and it is fragmented and completely sterile. That could be used as a household waste in this way, and should put in white bags so that it is very clear that it is fragmented, and so no one can use it, and to differentiate between it and the black bags for household waste. And then this bag transferred to the room for black bags to be taken with the cup. Here we have the third part for the red bags. Here we wash the trolley, and there is also an air gun to dry the trolley after washing. And then the storage room. And finally, the leg room for leg bags. And also, we segregate cartons and glass and cans and plastics, and we could buy it and we could sell it and take and this money compensate for the buying for the هيئة النظافة والتجميل بالمحافظة الجيزة. This is the waste and this is the fragmented waste. And the unit والحقيقة لجنة زرع الأعضاء لما جت عندنا في المعهد الحقيقة ادت لوحدة النفايات ووحدة التعليم المركزي 100%، وفعلا احنا حصلنا معنا شذور ان احنا ممكن نعمل زرع الأعضاء. خلاص. في طبعا انتيبيوتيك بوليسي، وكان لها نتيجه جامده جدا في ان احنا نقلل نسبه الميرسا ونسبه الاسبل عندنا. والحقيقه بحب اختم المحاضره بان كل منا له دور فليكتشفه على الفور، يعني بي ذا ميسنج بيس. work in a team, otherwise we dream and work in peace, otherwise we cease. And هدف واحد فريق أقدر وهدف واحد طريق أقصر ودعم القيادات بيزيد العقبات ومن يدركه الفرد تدركه الجماعة ودايما نبدأ بنفسنا ما نستناش ان احنا نقول اصل كل حاجة حوالينا مش مظبوطة والناس كلها مش كويسة لا احنا كل واحد فينا يبدأ بنفسه وقد يدفعك البعض للوراء لكن تابع سيرك بعزم وإباء مهما كان الطريق طويلا نستطيع ان نعبر الفجوة سويا مش لوحدنا وهنا الحقيقة دوت يعني منجم ده منجم الماس وماس وان هو هنا قاعد يحفر وبعدين لما خلاص قرب يوصل ف never give up to pick the diamond up وبنقول بقى innovation نختار يعني innovation or evaporation يعني نتجدد او نتبدل فعلينا ان احنا نختار لازم نحدد اللي احنا عايزينه ونصمم عليه ونعمله هنا طبعا فرق بين الدكتور اللي يعني واقف كده ومش عايز يسمع كلام حد ومش لابس اللبس وكده وبين الملتزم برضو هنا العمليات لابس الماسك مش لابسه ولابسين شربات وبتاع هنا طبعا دول ملتزمين المعامل برضو نفس الحكاية وفي المطبخ وإحنا بأيدينا نغير واقعنا مفيش عفاريت تيجي تغيرنا من برة إن الله لن يغير ما بقوم حتى يغيروا ما بأنفسهم لا يغير وكل أعماله وسأرى له عملكم ورسوله هو المؤمنون ورسوله هو المؤمنون وطبعا إحنا النهاردة كلنا كويسين لكن إن شاء الله بكرة نبقى أفضل ولا يبقى أفضل نجيب ورقة نسقفه ونعمل له كده
هي النجم الاستاذ الدكتور هلا بدوي ويمكن الكام سلايد حلوين اول وطبعا كلام عن الانفكشن بيكون كلام جميل احنا عندنا تيم الانفكشن بيكون عندنا ازاي نبطل بجد مع الاستاذ الدكتور ياسمين صلاح اكيد عامل مواجهه الحاجات دي وبرضه انا عايز اقول لحضراتكم ان احنا بدانا الانفكشن بيكون في مرض سنه ثالثه وبياخدوه دلوقتي في السكيلز لاب يلبس التكنيك كوفيد ازاي بيتسكلاب ازاي وبدانا كورس تاني يمكن مع الدكتوره هميمه وحتى من قبل الدكتوره هميمه مع اطباء امتياز بنعمل 6 كورسات في السنه لاطباء امتياز وانت كلمت طبعا
هميمه معانا يعني الدكتوره ياسمين عندها صغير وبعدين الدكتور حسين يعني على اساس ان احنا عدينا التايم كتير قوي اتفضل
بشكر الدكتوره هاله محاضره شيقه جدا وحضرتي خطيتي موست اوف ذا بوينت اللي تارجت انفكشن كنترول يعني ماي اوبينيون ان كان كل واحد لوحده محاضره لوحده كان هنبقى ساتسفايد لكن كانت اكتر حاجه كانت عجباني جدا فيديوهات نورمال هارس الحقيقه ما اشتغلناش مع حضرتك حاجه اشتغلنا مع النص واللقاح لكن ان شاء الله في الايام القادمه يبقى مع بعض شغل باذن الله بشكر حضرتك انا جاست هاف كومنت بس يعني hospital infection control nowadays is replaced with hospital acquired infection أو health care acquired infection ما عدناش بقول hospital infection control أي واحد مريض بتعالج في منشأة صحية أو حتى في البيت ومعزول ده لازم يطبق عليه معايير infection control اللي قالتها الدكتورة بس طبعا بنعمل لها reduction شوية تاني حاجة موضوع الستاف اوريس الجميل حضرتك عملتيه ده الاوت بريك اللي حصل في الستودنت هوستل بتاع جامعة الأزهر زي ما نيوز قالت المكونات العنقودية الذهبية If it's right, this means the hand of the worker is the cause of the food poisoning يعني الموضوع كان بس غسيل ايد ولا موردين ولا رئيس الجامعة الدف ولا حد له ده just the health care workers because الستاف اوريس دي موجودة في ايدينا وفي النوز وفي الأكزيلا ايه بروبر هاند هايجين سهل قوي انك تنقل مع الفود وتعمل الفاست دايريا اللي هي من 4 ل 6 ساعات ده بس كومنت تاني وزي ما الدكتور محمد بيعلق على سكيل لاب احنا فعلا ببراكتس بنحاول نعلمها للطلبه في سنه ثالثه وفعلا احنا شغالين بقى 5 سنين مع الامتياز نفس السكيلز اللي حضرتك قلتيها كده بس وذ مور براكتس ان شاء الله كما وعدنا الدكتور مجاهد السنه الجايه هيبقى لنا سيشن كامله نقول احنا عملنا ايه في كل قسم من اقسام في البطنه والرسائل اللي تمت، وحضرتك طبعا معانا مشرفانا ان شاء الله. بشكر حضرتك جزيل الشكر وبشكر الاوسي كلهم. شكرا.
دلوقتي محاضره كامله، فطبعا احنا بنعتذر على هذا الاجهاد وعلى قدر ان العزم تاتي العزائمه. احنا يعني جزء بس من التقدير البسيط. هتفضل الاستاذ طول مجاهد ابو المال رئيس المؤتمر رئيس الاقسام، هقدم لحضرتك بس درع يعني تقديرا يعني للمجهود اللي حضرتك بذلتيه معانا.